in about 3 hours' time. He was due to go over to the barn and doll himself up, as Sid put it. He spent the time in quiet meditation, alternating with periods of cold panic and a very natural impatience. If he succeeded in his quest, he was quite sure that Penelope would never speak to him again. On the other hand, if he failed... Closing his eyes against the possibility and dire consequences of failure, Mr. Mildman screwed himself up to the sticking point. The clock on the mantelshelf ticked relentlessly, throwing the minutes with gleeful indifference over its shoulder. Chapter 13. Inspector Meredith Gets Cracking. Inspector Meredith mounted the steps of New Scotland Yard with his customary springy step, issued a nod, a grin, and a brisk salute to the commissionaire at the door, and went through to his office. For the last 6 weeks he'd been investigating a particularly dull and unenterprising forgery case in Finchley, and he was feeling, to use his own phrase, about as lively as a Welsh evangelist on a wet Sabbath in Swansea. It was one of those cases calling for tremendous patience, a relentless attention to detail, and a strict adherence to an unswerving routine. In short, it was typical of the 99 out of 100 jobs that the average CID man is called upon to tackle. And from Meredith's jaundiced point of view, the case looked like stretching itself out for another 6 weary weeks. He stuck his lanky legs under his desk, sighed deeply, and began to collate material from a number of depositions he had recently placed on file. Barely had he got down to work, however, when the buzzer of the internal telephone sounded at his elbow.